Hello all. This is just an opening that I'm going to do, creating my character or whatever. I'm not sure what you do for the online exactly. I'll be playing this probably a little bit on my Cross Comics channel some Friday night where I have gaming there, as well as, you know, how I upload stuff here. Maybe I'll do some live stuff over here during the day. But, okay, so, we can only do online here, so let's play. Let's see, I want to make sure we're audio. I don't know why we don't have any audio here.
What? I don't like to be a Travis guy, yes.
Okay, let's see how to change appearance.
Doing with that?
like 16. Let's see what we got. Okay, so I don't think I can. Okay, so I think that's going to be about it. Go and get your big. Bring your hands up off your chest. Processing mugshot. I love that. Play intro. Want to know the basics of Red Dead Online? I've got a whole... Some months later. Siska Penitentiary Mail Wing. Graphics are pretty good.
What are you looking at? Go on, get home. You.
Looks like there I am.
You with the hammer. And you'll do. We need to perform a work detail out near Tumbleweed. Come on, get in. Open the gate. Come on, Milton. Tell you what, old Jameson is a wretched, sour old bastard. No mistake. Not stay calm in there.
We weren't saying nothing.
We are now. Shut up. Now, my wife has acquired ideas significantly above her station. She's reading too many goddamn books. Personally, I'm against education. Women, I mean. Men, I guess. Unnecessary. Doesn't add much to the world.
Nice scenery.
Education. Good day, gentlemen. Oh, don't do anything stupid. Nobody gets shot. Act like fools. A pair of you will be dead within a minute. Now, what are your names? Jenkins. Mr. Milliken. Well, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken. Throw your guns to the ground and get on down here. That's it. Very glad to meet you. It's not worth being a rat. You boys get paid a salary. You get that salary whether these people escape or not. Your wives presumably want you alive. Let them out. Now, please. Okay. Okay. All run away. Aside from you. Try to stay out of trouble. This is a stroke of good fortune for all of you. Use it. Now, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken, so kind as to quickly run away before somebody gets shot entirely unnecessarily. Go on, don't look back. Mr. White, I believe it was $50 we agreed on.
It was.
$50 each.
Each?
Yes. Now get out of here, both of you. My employer and I appreciate your professionalism.
All we did was stand there and look tough.
You did fantastically well. Good day, gentlemen. Yes, sir. How about you pick up these guns? We'll move out. The mistress is waiting for us. Forgive the secrecy. My employer particularly values discretion.
My name is Mr. Horley, by the way. 6 months in Sister Penitentiary, awaiting a hanging for a murder you did not commit, must have felt a whole lot longer, my friend. You still seem strong, though. I mean, it doesn't look like breaking all those rocks unless you were entirely broken, body or spirit. I hope I am right about that. Now that you folks up, those sham trials, they were a disgrace. Made a mockery of the rule of law. Still can't quite believe they got away with it. There's others convicted when you were. They now breathe with fire. Maybe you're like that too. Guess we'll see. Maybe. Just want to put it all behind you, forget you were in there at all. That will be fine, of course. You will listen to my mistress first. Spent a good sum getting you folks out. You owe her an audience, please. Just up here. There's the camera. Get your horse. Tie it here.
Okay. That was a nice ride.
Madam, we're back.
No. Just the clerk, how did you? What did you tell him?
Nothing, as we discussed.
Thank you, Corey. I do hope you have your convenience ready. But seeing as you were due to be hanged in a week, I'm sure you don't object strongly. I know you're innocent. Not guilty of what you were accused. I know you and those who were with you that died, you let them all than cats. But you were set up by one free man or a woman, possibly by all of them. I'm pretty sure. But that is all I know so far.
And one of these people also made Mrs. LeClerc the widow.
I will avenge my husband's death, so help me God. But I will not avenge it upon them who did not cause it. Or caused it unwittingly. Well, I'm sure this is all a touch of confusion in your life. Ah, what are my manners? Corley, please show our men to their tent and give them some fresh clothes to put on.
Very good, madam.
Then set us both a little refreshment.
Certainly, madam. This way. You'll find a change of clothes in there, alongside a few other items you might need, a lasso, a knife, and a lantern.
There we go. We see some had some other coolers, but we'll have to get to those at a different time. Thank you. gubbit pants. There we go. Both those ones. Get some spurs, yeah. I'm gonna check my code again. You know what? I'm gonna go with no code. Okay, so we're gonna. But exiting wardrobe will finalize your starting post. Are you sure you want to leave?
That looks more comfortable, Pauling.
Here, madam.
You're very good health. I suppose if you die.
This is LeClerc's husband who was murdered. One of his business partners.
And I intend to find out which one. Or rather, I intend for you to find out. And kill them. You're the only person I could possibly trust if you could ever tell me. Because you and your accomplices, you're the only other victims of their lives still alive. See, you walked into the town at approximately the same time my husband was shot in the back, but by another gun, firing different bullets to those you possessed and you arrested. These bullets. This was their mistake. You were rounded up and sentenced to death. All because you came to town, didn't talk too much, and seemed like you were nasty. Anyway, here they are. The people who run Blackwater. Mr. Jeremiah Shaw, banker, real estate speculator, and crook. Mr. Amos Lansing, ranch owner, speculator, and crook. Mrs. Grace Lansing, his wife, society patroness, lover of the arts, crook, my former best friend. Eddie Brown, ex-slave's brother, outlaw, wanted man, still in contact with him. All I ask of you is your help in finding out quite what happened.
Mrs. LeClerc would like to help you get back on your feet, back to work.
Whatever your word may be, I don't judge. You want to rob? Rob. You want to save innocent folk? Do that as well. But you need me just as much as I need you. I think we all understand each other.
I hope we do.
Good. I look forward to rewarding you for killing those who would be a widow. My husband was there. She was a leader in this country and the West. He was killed for greed. Foul greed. It was quite enough for everybody. I don't care what your scruples are to kill him. I will take the full burden of that sin upon my shoulders. Goodbye for now. Then Hawley, you'll introduce him to Nurse's decree.
I think your leg grips well enough. Long past his prime, of course, but he hasn't gone entirely crazy just yet. And he will help you better than most of his ilk. Crips! Get up!
Hello, partner. Hawley.
This is your new boss.
Oh, pleased to meet you, partner. J.B. Crips at your service.
Real pay to get your camp established. Mrs. LeClerc is a generous benefactor.
And where are we headed?
Sir, while Crips is establishing your camp, you have to go to the station to see the clerk, then head to see Clay Davis. He's a horse thief, a terribly nice one. Then meet Crips back at your camp.
Surely, boss.
Good luck.
Ooh, that's a long way. I wish this horse would more than just walk.
Well,
wish we could know how to make it run.
alone. You must be a Orin's friend. He's one of us. He said you also were a discouraged man. I'm very discouraged. Disappointed all people. That's me. Anyway, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. How about your reticence, Charlie? Real charming. By the way, I heard you might want to earn a little money. Well, some gentlemen have been robbing our stages. They are not part of the club, if you catch my drift. If you can make them go away, I'm sure they will have something of interest to you. They're up near Gatton Bridge. See what you can do, okay? Here, by the way, a catalog. The latest issue just came into this armpit from a land more civilized. And if all works out well, my colleagues and I move around these stations as needed. And all of us are very discouraged. We will all help a fellow sufferer with pertinent information. Good afternoon, sir.
Thank you.
Well, there we go. The skate bike. Let's see. Thank you. Thank you. forget what I have to press to. Get that inventory.
Thank you.
I think this is where I'm going to end here. Thanks for tuning in. Remember to like, share, subscribe. Went a little bit further than what we're intending, but we got to. It's hoping to get ahead of the game for things. So we're going to quit game for now. Hopefully we've got, oh, we'll say normal. Let's see, can we save? I don't even know whether we can save. Hopefully we are saved where we are. So that's it. Later. Bye for now. God bless.